have any hardness. You don't have any pain again. Your heritage that anything that you touch shall be a blessing to you because you have paid the price. The hands were nailed. Hallelujah. Bible says anywhere our feet will reach, that land shall be a blessing. It's a heritage. The wherever people are, they are suffering. When you go there, that place must be a blessing. Where your feet shall reach, that land shall be a fruitful field. Even when it was a forest, it will become a fruitful field. When it was a desert, once you go there, it will become a fruitful field. Why? Because your the hands, the feet of somebody receive spines, nail, blood come out, and you have been made free. Your feet have been made free. So that wherever you go, there will be a blessing. So think of it. Are you thinking of it? Is somebody here thinking of all that Jesus has done for him or her? All that he has done for us, he has left a heritage for us. That when we believe him, all these things I'm saying shall follow us. Whatever you will touch, whatever you will touch, will be a blessing in Jesus' name. He said, whatever you will do in my name, whatever you ask in my name, I will do it. Because he has paid the price for you already. That is your heritage. Think of it. At the time he was born, angels were there. The time he was resurrecting, angels were there. But when he was going to die, angels weren't there. Because that time, that was the most critical time of his life. Because of you and I, they have abandoned him. At one point, he said, Father, Father. He was crying for the eternal spirit. God. Nobody was there to help him. Angels were there when he was born. Angels were there when he was right. They took the stone away. But when he was suffering, he was abandoned. Why have you forsaken me? He cried. Hallelujah. Why he was abandoned was that because that was the moment he has to pay the price for you and I. That was the heritage he was leaving for us. That anyone who believes on him, he shall become heirs to that property. A property of being saved. A property of being having a glorious body. A property of being healed. A property of being protected. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. He left all those things for us. The only problem we have that we have not recognized what the Lord has left for us. And because we have not recognized the magnitude, the beauty, the glory, the preciousness of what the Lord has left for us, we do things in the house of God or we worship God anyhow because we do not understand the end result of what we are doing. So the problem we have is that we have this heritage in our hand and we are giving it out to the enemy. Somebody say, God forbid, that I will give the inheritance to my enemy. Hallelujah. Amen. There was this man from the book of 1 Kings chapter 21, whom the king said, I love your vineyard. It's very close to me. I'll give you a better one. If you like, I'll pay with silver and gold. You can do anything with it. And the man said, God forbid that I will give to you the inheritance of my fathers. My king said, who are you? Can you compare yourself to the God that I worship? But many of us, we have sold our inheritance out. We have sold our salvation out for a little thing. In the book of Genesis, Bible said Esau sold his birthright. For what? You see the kind of porridge it is? Because he was very hungry. And some of us, because of the little problem we are going through, we have sold our heritage out. Ladies and gentlemen, God will not take you to that far where you will die out of hunger. Even if you will die out of hunger, why don't you join Esther and said, oh, if I perish, I perish. Why? Today, because they can't understand what it means to inherit the kingdom of God, otherwise to enjoy eternity, they allow the little span of life they have here to rule over their eternity. Hallelujah. Amen. They have considered their 70 years of their interest and sold their birthright because they want to live well. They want people to see them. They want to have, they are self-centered. They want to live in a place where people will come and worship them. But what do you gain if they worship you today and tomorrow you are in hellfire? What do you gain if you enjoy your body today and you really enjoy yourself today just to end up in hellfire forever? The Lord has come and make a way, for the way is very narrow. It's a narrow way indeed. There are many obstacles. The Christian life is not easy, but it's a heritage. Somebody has suffered for that and leave this heritage for us. All we need to do is to struggle and make sure we don't lose what the man has left for us.
Amen.
All of us, we are having this heritage, but we don't know. For little things, we have sold it out. Either to old men, old women, to drinking, to smoking, many other social vices. That has caused us to lose our heritage. We get involved in business that God will never accept. We find ourselves in places that is not of God. We get involved in things that the Lord will not accept. And for that cause, we lose our heritage just because we want to enjoy this life. But this life is only for a short period. The problem is still, I'm asking God, when are you taking me home? Nobody knows when God is coming to take you. It's a moment of time that things are very difficult. But to every Christian, there is a way for you. Somebody has made the way already. The only thing we need to do is to obey. Obey. Obey and take our inheritance. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Have you thought of it? The man was bruised.